is heading toward the future for Lawson Ensemble. I think we want to collaborate more with our students here in various ways. And so, thank you. So, getting to perform with my wife's singers and joining them for a program is great. And then, you know, this is the ninth year that we've been playing concerts at UNF. And from the very start, one of the big things was Cara and I doing concerts together. So we thought that would be a great way to finish out the ninth year. Also, the violinist that's joining us on this program, Karina, is a former master's student from UNF, so not quite a student, but in the family, right? And Karina and Arika are both from Moldova, so they share that in common. And then the other thing that I'm excited about is for you all to get to hear Sachiko Frampton play, if you haven't already. Sachiko coming to UNF, however long ago it was such an incredible thing for both me and Cara. Sachiko plays with almost all of my cello students and is just incredible. And then she's been the collaborator for Cara's choral ensembles for the last few years and has made Cara's life a lot easier too. So we're really eager to play this concert for you, and I just wanted to welcome everyone here and thank you for coming. So hope you enjoy.
Oh, Thank you.
forward, so Erika's violin is really mad at her right now.
Thank you. because of a lot of unwelcoming words that we were hearing tossed around toward refugees, we began the Refugee Corps. And I had the distinct pleasure of working with Catholic Charities Bureau of Jacksonville and Lutheran Social Services of Northeast Florida. And I've asked Clara James tonight to come join us and share a little bit about what the process is, because I learned so much that I had not understood about resettling in the United States and what it means. And I'm glad that the students have come out early so that they can hear it. So please welcome Clara James to the stage.
Social Services of Northeast Florida, and I work with the Refugee Services Department. And a little bit of background, Lutheran Social Services, we provide lots of resources for the community, but one of the most impactful things that we have is our refugee program. Last year alone, we served, along with the other resettlement agencies in Jacksonville, over 2,500 people that were coming into the country. That was just last year alone. And we feel like we're gonna top that number this year. Many of the people are coming from all over the world. We have several families that have recently arrived from Central America, Guatemala, El Salvador, Nicaragua. We also have people coming in from the Democratic Republic of Congo, Afghanistan, Cuba, you name it. If there's a crisis somewhere where people are trying to flee for their lives, whether it's because of war, religious persecution, or any other type of attack on them where they're not safe, they'll leave their countries. And this is where the process starts. And it's a very long process, which is actually something I recently learned myself, even though I've been in this field for some time. It could take up to 2 years just to be vetted to come into the United States. Oftentimes, it takes many more years than that. It starts with an application to the United Nations High Council for Refugees, where they have background checks. Their eyes are scanned, facial scans, health evaluations are done on them, on people. And once they're decided to come into the United States, there are 8 government agencies that are doing interviews, background checks on them as well, before they get access to come into the country. After that, they are placed with one of 9 national placement organizations. Our parent for Lutheran Social Services is Global Refuge. And Global Refuge for us decides where in the United States they're gonna go. If a refugee family or a person comes to the United States and they have connections here, they are trying to be placed with people that they know. If not, it's just where there's availability for them. Oftentimes, they are coming to Jacksonville and they have no one here that they know. So it can be very scary and very daunting. What we do for them, we help set up apartments for them. We give them special services for the first 6 months, which is helping them get their benefits that they need, helping them find employment. They sign up through the refugee program. It's help, financial help as well. But everyone that comes through, adults, if they're able to work, we help find them employment. And the children, we get them enrolled in school, and all of the adults are enrolled in English as a second language classes, which we work with Catholic Charities for that one. And that's the first 6 months. There's a lot going on in those 6 months, but we provide services for them for the next 5 years, which can include providing them childcare, any other type of resource that they need. If they change a job or something happens at work, we know it's not always easy for us who are here. We can still help them for 5 years trying to get employment. That way, special trainings for them to help them improve their skills. We recently started a women's group called SHE, where we're helping the women who can't make it out of the house too often, or for other reasons. We're giving them special English classes. They're learning certain skills that perhaps their own abilities, they can learn how to monetize on them and possibly start their own business so they can help bring an income into the home. And recently, which is why I'm at Lutheran Services, we have a program called Circle of Welcome, which is a small group of volunteers that get together and they help guide a family alongside with us for the first 6 months that they're here. So there are many ways if you are interested in helping, whether it's a longer commitment or you want to try to do a one-time thing, could be a, helping set up a new apartment for them, or maybe providing transportation one day. There are many ways, and you can always go on our website to find out. We have more information there. And I also do a lot of info sessions to give more information out into the community at lssjax.org. I don't want to keep talking and hold these guys up. I know you came to see the show. And I do have flyers outside if you're interested. You can always stop me after the show to talk some more. Thank you. Did you learn something you didn't know? It's amazing, isn't it? I'm so glad you're here. And
glad to be here.
Thanks for sharing that with us. So the next piece we're doing, and our final piece on the program, is Refugié, mon frère, refugee, my brother. And there's a point in the piece, it's in French, I think the students put in translations for you, but there's a point in the piece where the choir will start humming, and you'll hear talking, and I know my mom's out there, and she'll go, what were they saying? I couldn't hear them. So if you'd like to also join us in that, you're saying, my brother, we are all travelers. Essentially, considering the fact that you could have been born anywhere in the world, I'm very lucky to have been born where I was born, and circumstances could be completely different. And it's impossible to imagine what the experience is like for someone who's going from refugee camp to camp to camp, then waiting 2 years to be vetted to get to safety. This piece is by Sidney Guillaume. Normally, they're a cappella songs with percussion and very rhythmic and lots of tangents. This one is the only one he has for string quartet and piano and treble voices. Not listed in the program is soloist Cora Grace Smith and Gabrielle Slavos, who will be joining us at the beginning and the end. And I invite you at the end, if you wanted to say hello to our students and also to Mrs. James, to hear more about it. It would be great. Thank you for coming.